Cheers, Rose. Woo! Hi.
So, you know, I hadn't heard about the loop. Most people I talked to never heard about it. So National Geographic came out with an article this year talking about it being such a great trip and a trip that no one's ever heard of, and that's kind of true. You know, of course it's out there, but with the pandemic, it's become pretty popular. People are buying boats and starting the trip, and I hope that they, you know, are able to finish because there are many beautiful places to see here. In the United States, we have a connection of waterways. Some of them are natural, some are man-made, but they comprise a loop around the eastern United States. It's about 6,000 miles.
So you just get on a boat and choose a spot to start, and you go around multiple states through water on your boat, and then when you cross your wake where you started, that, you know, ends your trip.
People are traveling the entire loop, and when they do, they end up crossing their wake. That's something that we call completing the loop, you know, it's crossing your wake, and that's something special. And there's an organization now that will have you fly a flag. So if you're on that part of the United States, you can tell if people are on the loop or not, if they're trying to accomplish it. The first boat I chose was a 10-year-old boat. It was 26 feet long. It was a tritune, and I went alone. The trip was about 1,400 miles. I picked up my brother in Florida, and we spent a couple of days together. But at that point, I had met a lockmaster along the way in the inland rivers, and he told me I shouldn't cross the Gulf of Mexico on that boat, and he was right, because basically, it's too small for the Gulf of Mexico, but there are safe ways to do it. So I went out south of Apalachicola and went straight across. That's about 160 miles, something like that. The safer way to do it, I think I would recommend, is to go out to a place called Alligator Point and then wrap around the Big Bend of Florida. But I had a good day of weather, so it worked out. That was the first boat. The second boat I used, well, at that point I thought I needed a bigger boat, so I was going to trade boats out. I ended up buying a smaller boat. So this one was 24 feet, had a bigger motor on it, and a friend of mine, Andre, joined me in Florida. So we took off from Sarasota, we fished in the bay, caught quite a few fish that day, and then we headed around through Lake Okeechobee and then up the East Coast. We made it to Southport, North Carolina, and at that point there are some big waterways there. So Andre and I, we'd gone through some great times, maybe 10% of the time, some rough times.
There was about two or three instances that we had that I want to say you start thinking about, am I going to survive this kind of thing, you know? But I think that, you know, going through those bad moments, one thing that I found was that it doesn't matter, or it didn't matter, whatever we went through, at the end of the day, we were able to dock somewhere and be safe. And I've been thinking a lot about that lately, like with life, you know, an analogy with being on a boat and going through something really rough that it's kind of life-threatening and you're like, oh, I don't know if I'm gonna survive this, to at the end of the day, you know, you're safe on the dock. Everyone goes through hard times, but you know, we overcome things. And with the loop, it was the same situation. You know, we had hard times, but we overcame those hard times. We're able to dock and be safe. And with life, I feel like, you know, I will always remember this. You know, like, you know, whatever I'm going through right now, I know that this is just a moment, and it will pass, and I'll be fine. You know. So
over time, it took 4 years, three boats, 4 years. We only traveled 34 days. So that might, you know, I think if we're looking at some of the highlights of the trip, that's kind of one of the highlights for me, is that we were able to do it like that. So if a person had great weather, the right boat, they could do it super fast. But it doesn't really work that way. There are just so many things that come up during the trip. We had Joel DeBrosse was with me, my nephew. We picked him up in New York City. First thing he saw was the Statue of Liberty, so that was awesome. And then we traveled through the entire Erie Canal, and the end of that, we saw Niagara Falls, which is beautiful and something I'd never seen before.
What I'll cherish the most is the friendships that I was able to build on the trip with Andre and Scott. They're both great, great people. I didn't know Andre before this trip started, and I got to learn, you know, how kind and how kind he was. Obviously, you know, I know Scott very well, but I never really got to spend that much time with him. So the friendships that I got to build and the sights that I got to see, those are going to be the biggest things that I cherish the most. So like in the mornings, one thing that I just absolutely loved, we would wake up in the morning, and especially if you got out there and you were the very, very first boat on the water would just look like glass, like you were on glass. You know, even though you had an engine going behind you, all you could do is look out in front of you and just, you would just see that you were just gliding across. I mean, it almost felt like clouds, you know, when you really just looked at it.
You know, taking my guard down and showing them like how I am in not in a working or, you know, situation or a different, like more relaxed set. I think friendships, and, you know, we developed that, you know, throughout the trip as we got to know each other better. Another friendships with people that we met on the loop, you know, we were able to meet a lot of, for example, John, a mechanic that really saved us when we had boat trouble in Annapolis. He's a great guy. I consider him a friend.
Everybody that's out there, I just felt like everybody was rooting for everybody.
Yeah.
You know, even though everybody was on their own vessels, and it's just the community is way, way bigger than you could
supportive.
Even imagine in
right.
the Great Loop.
Exactly.
We had everything from, you know, you guys are crazy from doing it to I want to join you. Yeah, so life is short, and I spent time, you know, by myself. I got to think about things. My family is number one, and taking a little time away so that I could see it, I think actually helps, because now when I go to the games, I just appreciate it. I just love watching Reed play, and thinking about my daughters in college and how they're doing well, it just gives me so much happiness to think about them doing their own thing. Carol has been by my side steadfastly the whole time, so I just appreciate her so much, and if you knew me before, you probably wouldn't hear that as much, so I just want her to know that as well. My friendships, I can rely on people. Those bonds that you build are strong, they're lifelong. So I think if people are looking for, you know, a sense of trying to accomplish something in life, the Great Loop's great for that. The obvious thing about the Loop is you're seeing a lot of beautiful places and seeing it from a unique kind of a way